started with the chapter Happy Prince. What we have read in Happy Prince, that there was a prince who was called as Happy Prince. Why he was called as Happy Prince? It is because of the reason that Sorrow was never allowed to enter his palace. And moreover, he has never encountered any kind of sorrow and worry in his entire life. And after his death, the statue was built. The statue was built. It was beautifully made, gilded with gold sheets. Okay, wearing a ruby on its forehead, and two sapphires were making his eyes. Right, and what happened? The statue now as it was situated on the tall column. So the happy prince now he is able to see the suffering, the worries, and the type of life the people were living. They were not at all happy. He was so deeply moved, or he was deeply moved by the worries of the people. So what I thought, one day a swallow came and who alighted its flight at the base of the statue near its feet. And Happy Prince requested the swallow to stay with her one day, as he has seen a seamstress who was embroidering the flowers on the satin gowns of the queen's maids of honor. So he requested to give this ruby to the woman, as his only son was lying on the bed, who was suffering from fever. Okay, as he was suffering from fever, and ultimately the swallow agreed to this point. He has taken the ruby from the sword hilt and flew towards the house where that seamstress lived. So now let us see how the swallow will hand over the ruby to the woman. So see, I'm reading from thank you little swallow. Move from that side. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. So prince said, thank you, little swallow. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword. So what he did, the swallow, what he did? He has picked up the ruby from the sword, from the prince's sword, and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. And it flew away to rise on the roofs of the town. So in order to hand over that ruby to the seamstress. Students are entering now. We have started earlier. I don't know. So he passed by the cathedral tower. Cathedral means it is a great palace which is supported by tall columns, towers. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. So this is the palace from where it passed. Beautiful marble, beautiful sculptures. They are carved out of marble that supported the cathedral. And he passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. So while the swallow was passing through that cathedral tower, he has heard the sound of dancing. It means that the people were rehearsing or they were performing that ballroom dance. And a beautiful girl, she came on the balcony with her lover and she was talking. What she was discussing, I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball. She said, I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. So what is the view of the maid of honor? Who's that girl? She is one of the queen's maid of honor. So she was talking with her lover. She's saying that I wish that my gown will be ready well in time, as I have told to embroider flowers over it. But the seamstress, she's not doing her work well in time. I think that she is so lazy. So he passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the mast of the ship. What is mast of the ship? It is the outer edge of the ship, you can say, which is responsible for stopping the air and propelling the ship forward. Okay, so this is called as mast of the ship. Lanterns were lighting above on the masts on the ships. At last, he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. Finally, the swallow covered his distance over the palace, and then it has moved over the ships. And finally, it has reached to the woman's house. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed. and the mother had fallen asleep. So see, the boy, because when you are suffering from fever, you are not able to sleep, right? So the boy, he was tossing feverishly from one side to another because he was unable to sleep. Moreover, he wanted or he wished to eat oranges, which his mother was unable to provide him. So what happened? He was tossing from one side to another as he was not able to sleep there. And the woman, because of her hard work, because she was so tired after embroidering the flowers. So what happened? She was so tired that she felt asleep. In he hopped, hopped means jumped. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table besides the woman's thimble. Thimble is a, you can say covering that is to be worn over the thumb, okay, which is used for embroidery, right? So the woman, the swallow, it flew around, it came through the window, and what it has done, it has placed that ruby on the table, which was beside the woman's thimble. On the table, woman's thimble was also placed, and he has placed the ruby on the side of the thimble on the table. Then he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. "How cool I feel," the boy said. "I must be getting better." And he sank into a delicious slumber. Delicious means peaceful here. Slumber means deep sleep. Okay, so what he said, so the swallow, it has flown around the bed of the boy because he was feeling so tired and so hot, and so you can say he, so much of heat was there, so he was feeling relaxed when the swallow flew, and with its wings it fanned the air around. The boy felt relaxed. He said, "Oh, thank God, little bit cool I felt." And after that he slept on his bed. And he has a sound sleep. He has gone to a deep sleep. He passed over the river and saw the land. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. "It is curious, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold." So see, the swallow, it has gone back to happy prince. So it has told the entire episode to Happy Prince that this has happened and I have done that. I have given that ruby to this, in this manner, I have dropped the ruby on the side of the table, and where the thimble was placed, I fanned the boy, and ultimately he felt too relaxed. So Happy Prince was also very happy that at least he is able to help any one of his countrymen. Right? So the swallow also felt too relaxed. What the swallow said? The swallow also said, "Even I'm feeling too warm now, although it is very cold." So what this kind of warmth is? He was feeling peaceful, happy, relaxed, contented, satisfied. Okay? So he was having that feeling of satisfaction, that feeling of contentment. So this the writer wants to deliver to us is that if we help others, if we have soft corners, if we have feeling attitude towards the feelings of others, okay? So that ultimately it not only makes us good in the house of God, moreover, it is also providing us relaxation. It is also providing us contentment, self-satisfaction. And this is the kind of warmth that swallow was feeling at that time. So then that is because you have done a good action. And said, "You are feeling warmth, although it is very cold outside, because you have done a great action. This is a great action by you. You have done a good deed, and your good deed is providing you warmth." And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleep. So the swallow, he has gone into deep thoughts, and these kind of deep thoughts that always make the swallow to sleep. And the swallow has also gone to sleep. So what is this? This means that if you have helped someone, if you have done out of the way to someone, okay, by going out of the way to someone, see, swallow, he has sacrificed his flight to go to Egypt. He has lagged behind his friends, but ultimately what he has done, he has helped that woman although the ruby was provided by Happy Prince, but still he has sacrificed his flight. So as he has sacrificed his flight, he has gone there. So what is this? This is ultimately a great job done by the swallow. Okay. So this has, of course, you can say, this has, of course, provided him contentment, satisfaction. This is the reason why he has gone into deep sleep. Otherwise, if you are not helping others, if you are having, you can say, annoying nature, if you don't, if you have an unfeeling behavior towards others or unfeeling attitude towards others, then what is there? You will also not rest at peace. Never. Somehow and somewhere, these thoughts are always pricking up your mind. You always feel, yes, I have done that. But ultimately, you are justifying yourself. Usne aisa kiya tha, tabhi to maine aisa kiya. But ultimately, this is one way of thinking. What is the other way? If he has done wrong, it is not necessary that we will also do wrong in return. Okay, why? It is just because of the reason that you, if you can be good, maybe the person will understand your goodness and can change himself. Okay, so let him do his part of karma and you will do your part of karma. Ultimately, what we send, it ultimately comes back to us, right? So, and when day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. So when the day broke means when it was morning, the swallow had gone to the river, had a bath. Tonight I go to Egypt. He was making the resolution. Swallow was saying that today I was going to Egypt. And he was in high spirits at the prospect. At the prospect means at this idea. High spirits means full of enthusiasm. Okay, full of, you can say, fresh energy. That yes, definitely today I'll go to Egypt. Okay, so he visited all the monuments and sat a long time on top of the church steeple. What is the church steeple? The top of the church where the cross is made. Okay, right. Okay, so he visited all the monuments, okay, great buildings, and it sat for a long time on the church steeple. Why on the church steeple? Because he was filled with satisfaction. He was filled with contentment. He did not want anything. He thought that I have done really a great deed. I have helped the seamstress. And today I will definitely go to my destination, that is Egypt. Okay. When the moon rose, he flew back to the Happy Prince. So when the moon rose, it was night. Night started to fall. The swallow, it has gone back to the Happy Prince. Have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried. I'm just starting. Have you any commissions? Have you any plans? Okay, to go to Egypt. And he said, I'm just starting. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you stay with me one night longer? Now the Happy Prince, he requested again the swallow to stay with him one more day. Now let us see whether the swallow will be ready. So before moving further, let us recapitulate the previous one. Yes. Why did the Happy Prince told the swallow to stay with him for one more day? To help the seamstress. Okay, yes, beta. Next one. Why did Happy Prince want to help the seamstress? Sit down. Next one. Very good. Okay. Right. Thank you. Sit down. So next, stand up. Why was seamstress not able to take care of her child? Why did the seamstress not able to take care of her child? She was busy in making the which clothes? Sit down, please. Yes. She was making clothes. Which kind of clothes she was making? Sit down. Next. She was very poor. And she was not well. No, seamstress was not suffering from any ailment. She was quite okay, but she was busy. Okay, yes, good job. Sit down. Good, very good. Because she was busy in embroidering the flowers on the gowns of maids of honor. It was not that she was making clothes, okay? You too, right? She was embroidering flowers on the gowns of the queen's maids of honor. And the queen's maids of honor, they write it, they need it in urgency as they have to wear those gowns at the state ball, right? Okay. So, how did the swallow come and drop the ruby into the seamstress house? Yes, last. Okay, sit down. Yes, Eva. How he dropped the ruby? Okay, right. Sit down. So it means that the swallow, it flew down from the mast of the ship and covered the distance to the seamstress house. And she and the swallow entered through the small window which was open of the house. And as the seamstress or as the woman was asleep because of being tired, and then what happened? The swallow, it fanned the boy with its wings and dropped the ruby onto the table near the thimble and flew away. Right? So this is how, right? So he has helped. So how did swallow feel after helping the seamstress? Yes. Your name, please. Harjot. Hargun. Yes, Hargun. How did swallow feel after helping the seamstress? Sit down, Vatsal. How did swallow feel after helping the woman? See, sit down, please. So, just listen to me carefully. First of all, tell me happy, satisfied, contented, okay? Elated. What is the difference between these feelings? Can you provide a synonym of happy, that of like you can say satisfied? No. So if it doesn't mean that for every answer you have common words, okay? Choose the exact word, okay, what you want to deliver, okay? Because only after choosing the right word you will be able to give proper answer, okay? So being like he has said that the swallow was happy. He was not at all happy. No happiness, satisfied. He was filled with contentment. He was feeling the warmth, although it was cold. Okay. So try to explain in context to the chapter. Okay. This is for, because you have to attempt now MCQs. So for that, you should be very particular about the word to be chosen. Okay. So sometimes we think, yes, this is the answer, but it is not always, right? Okay, choose the perfect, exact answer. So this is the reason why I want that you should know, you should have the deep knowledge of the story. What happened, where happened, when happened, how he felt, how she felt, everything else, right? So next afterwards, so we were thinking, now we were reading that, the happy prince has told the swallow to stay with him for one more day. So let us see what swallow says. I'm waited for in Egypt, swallow said. My friends are waiting for me in Egypt. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. Garret means it's a small house like that of a garage, including single room. He is leaning. Leaning means bending over. He's leaning over a desk covered with papers. So what does this signify? That he was sitting on a desk which is covered with papers, right? So what it means? What he is busy in writing. It means he's indulging himself in some kind of writing business, right? So, and in the glass, by his side, there is a bunch of withered violets. And on his side, what is there? A glass is placed, and in it, what are there? Withered violets. Withered violets means? Withered means who has shed its petals as well as its leaves. Because we can't say it is a plant. Bunch means group of flowers maybe. Okay, withered violets means flowers. Flowers of violet color. So what this signifies? See, the selection of the lines by the writer. So just in a para, he has displayed the complete picture, complete scene of the room. Withered violets means this also withered violets. It means that he was not in happy condition. Okay, he did not have enough money to support himself. This is the reason why the violets are withered. Moreover, he is so busy that he is not able to replace those violets, those flowers. This also shows his busyness, right? So withered violets were there. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as a pomegranate. And pomegranate, you know, the fruit? Okay. Pomegranate. And he has large and dreamy eyes. Dreamy eyes means full of dreams. He's thinking high of his future life. So what is there? So his lips are red as pomegranate, means he's well educated, also well civilized man. Of course, he is brown and with brown and crisp hair he was having, and his eyes are filled with dreams of his future aspirations. So he is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write anymore. So what he was doing, he was trying to write a play for director of theaters. It means that he was a playwright. Okay, spellings of playwright, play, then. What are the spellings of playwright? W-R-I-T-H-T, it is playwright. That he is a playwright, okay. So as he has to finish a play for the theater, for the director of the theaters, but he was not able to write anymore. Why he was not able to write anymore? Because he was suffering from cold. It was too cold weather that he could not help writing. Okay, his hands has turned out to be chilly. You can very well imagine this kind of condition. There is no fire in the grate. Grate means the chimney, which is in English homes, this is a trend. That in the room, there is a chimney where they kindle the fire with dry wood, small pieces of wood, and it provides warmth to them. So, in the fire in the grate, and hunger has made him faint. He has nothing to eat also, because you know when you don't eat anything, you feel devoid of energy, and ultimately what will happen? You lose all energy and you are unable to work. Okay? So, and hunger has made him faint. I will wait you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. So he said, I will wait with you one night longer. Swallow agreed. He has come to know that he has to go and help that man. So he said, of course, I will stay with you one more night. And said the swallow, who really had a good heart. It means swallow has also goodness in his heart. Okay. Tell him to sit properly. So, sit properly, Vatsal. Not feeling well? Headache or go to medical room. Huh? Just go and drink water. You will feel fresh. Okay. So, had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby for to the young playwright. He thought that the happy prince would ask him, take another ruby from my body and give it to the playwright. But he did not have another ruby to be given. So let us see what he will give. Alas, I have no ruby now. Happy prince said, oh, so sorry. I'm so sorry. I don't have any ruby with me left. The only ruby was there and that has been given to the seamstress. So my eyes are all that I have left. He said, there are only eyes which are made up of precious stones and this is all I left with. So this is what? This is the selfless service. It is not necessary. You will be selfish enough to think of yourself only. Just try to be selfless. Fill your heart with selfless love. Never to wait for the rewards and never to wait for the, you can say, benefits you will get after helping someone. So this is the true kind of service. So this chapter, it is, you can say, it is wrapped up in number of, you can say, themes and messages. So every line is a message. Okay. So what he said is, he said, I don't have any rupee now, but I have only my eyes are left and my those eyes which are made up of, they are made up of sapphires, which are very costly stones. They are made up of rare sapphires and those sapphires, these are rare ones, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. And what he said that these sapphires, they have been brought to me 1,000 years ago from India. It means that, see, in stories, it means that India was filled with jewels in older times, right? So this is written by an English writer and he has specially mentioned India. It means that India is famous all over the world for its jewels as well as its pearls. So he said, this is made, my eyes, they are made up of sapphires, which are very rare kind, which cannot be found everywhere. And what is this? It is just because of this reason that they are very costly stones. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. So what he said, please take one sapphire and pluck it out and give it to the playwright. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish the play, he said. Then after getting this sapphire, he will send it to the jeweler. He will get enough of money. He will buy the firewood and he will be able to finish his play. So, dear prince, Swallow said, I cannot do that. And he began to weep. How soft the heart of Swallow is. It's a so touching story. I mean, I like it most. In 9th class, this is one of the best story. And in 10th class, 100 dresses. When you will read that 100 dresses, you will feel that you are in the story. Because it is a story, very beautiful story about a girl named Wanda who was, you can say, who was bullied by the two girls of the class. Or she's always sitting at the last desk. Nobody's talking to that girl. And ultimately, she's always made fun of. Because in the school, the two girls, Peggy and Maddie, they are always wearing new dresses, daily changed ones. This happens in the class also. If one child is wearing some only one thing daily, so the other children say, "Tere paas yehi hai bas." This happens. This is nothing new. And the writer has brought up this, you can say, this theme of bullying in a very, you can say, elaborative. Two parts are there, 100 dresses one and 100 dresses two. Very beautiful story it is. And she is always wearing the one blue dress. And whenever all the girls, they are playing hopscotch. Hopscotch means kuch tapu nahi khelti hain girls ko. Hopscotch in the ground. Peggy would always ask Wanda, how many dresses you have? And what Wanda is replying, I have 100 dresses and all lined up in my closet. She's telling in this manner, all lined up in my closet. And but she did not have. She has all those 100 dresses in her imagination only. So what happened when the drawing contest was held? So everyone was thinking that Peggy would win the competition because she's a very good artist. Okay. And moreover, she's one of the girls with the highest grades in the class. She's one of the most popular girl in the school. Everyone was betting that Peggy would win the competition. And from boys, that boy would win the competition. But what happened? That competition, it was won by Wanda. Nobody knew that she was a very good artist. And finally, the teacher appreciated her drawings in the class. But when the teacher announced the result, Venda was not there. Venda has left the school along with her brother. Why? Because she was discussing each and every problem, that how she was teased, how she was tortured in the class. And ultimately, his father has decided, because my children, they are made fun of in the class, they have shifted to another city. Okay. And finally, he has written a letter. And when the teacher, she has read that letter in the class, there was complete silence in the class. This happens when you commit a mistake and teacher comes to know and teacher announces, then nobody is going to take the responsibility. And even at that time, Peggy was also not able to take the responsibility. She thought that it is not just because of her teasing that Venda has left the school. But why she has left the school? It is just because why she is telling that she has 100 dresses. If she is not having, why she is telling? Finally, both Peggy and Maddie was emotional girl. She was pricked by that thought that I have done wrong with Venda. So she thought, in order to repent for it, so they both decided to go to her house, which was situated in the Boggins Heights. And ultimately, when they have gone there, Venda was not found. Finally, Maddie was filled with this, you can say, suppressing desire that this time should ever come, that when I will get time and feel sorry from Venda. And next time she has also resolved that I will never be a part of the gang and I will never be a partner with Peggy to tease any child. So ultimately what happened, finally in the end, a letter from Venda came, in which she has told that I have made 100 dresses, and out of that the green one should be given to Peggy and the blue one to Maddie. Okay, and that moment they have realized that no, they were wrong. So it was very beautiful story, very elaborately and very beautifully explained by the writer. So this is the greatness of great writers, what I want to display. Okay. Greatness of great writers means to take the readers along the ride of your thoughts. When you read like this chapter, what we are reading, we are making a flight in the mind of the writer. Okay, so this is how. Some stories, they are so touching that you always are engrossed in the words. You are kept with the words, right? So we have gone off the topic. Actually, we were discussing Happy Prince. So then the next class, we will continue further, right? If you have any doubt, you can ask me now.